honor to be out here with you on the day that celebrates the struggles of workers and oppressed peoples all over the world. This is a day that was put aside so that the world would know that in spite of everything that is going on in the lives of people, that there are those of us who take a moment out to pay solemn respect to the shoulders upon which we stand. There would be no progressive movement anywhere in the world without the labor movement. The attempt to turn history back begins with the attempt to destroy the labor movement in the United States and to convince working people and people generally that you don't need a union, that you don't need to organize, that you don't need a decent wage, that you don't need health care. Now, one of the places where this is going on with a vengeance is throughout this country at universities. Universities, probably second only to hospitals and the so-called healthcare industry, are set up to make super profits, not to educate people. Look at the way the whole thing is set up. Students paying tens of thousands of dollars a year for tuition. They have to borrow that money. Workers, including most of the professors, being paid at minimum wage and below minimum wage. At Temple University, the current president has refused to meet with any of the unions. None of them, for the most part, have contracts. These unions have become neoliberal behemoths in the center of black and Latino working class communities in these cities. Now, to make a long story short, we're fighting back. As of January 2014, my contract will not be renewed, so they think. What they did not count upon is that I would stand up, that I would reach out to students, that I would reach out to the community, that I would reach out to the labor movement and ask for them to support me, and in supporting me, to support the people of North Philadelphia, to support the working people of Temple University, and to support the underpaid, super exploited adjuncts, graduate students, and non-tenured faculty. And that's the struggle we're waging. If those brave souls that founded International Working Day, International Working People's Day back in the 1880s were alive today, let me tell you where they'd be. They'd be up at Temple.
93.3 WFMR.
They'd be fighting against an administration that's a neoliberal group of elites who believe that people, students, and nobody else has any rights, that they need respect. And we intend to teach them a lesson. A lesson from the 19th century that we're going to teach them in the 21st century. That united we stand. That an injury to one is an injury to all. And when the question is asked, what side are you on? We're going to let them know that we professors, we students, we cafeteria workers, we maintenance workers, we the working people of Temple, we are all on the same side. In unity, there is strength, and we will win. Thank you very, very much. No peace, no justice. peace.
No justice.
No 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 peace.
No justice.
Thank you, Dr. Montero.